for coming out tonight. You could have been anywhere in the world, but you're here with me.
What's up, you guys? This is Waldo from Rock Entry, and today we're going to be talking about technique. How exactly do I train for technique? So I'm going to share with you guys six things that I do and share with you a typical day where I just focus strictly on technique. Now, before we get started, one of the things that I do is focus on climbs 2 to 3 grades below my max level. The reason why is this. I want to be able to climb as much as possible and work on these six things that I'm going to be mentioning as much as possible. Let's get started. Number one, visualization. I want to work on my visualization. I want to be able to read routes. I want to be able to figure out beta when I just look at the route. So the best thing that I can do to train this is to do this on each and every route on this day. So for instance, in this case, I'm looking at the holds and I figure out what type of holds they are, how am I going to place my body positioning, and what are the next holds that I'm going to go for once I get to a certain position. These are things that I'm thinking about. Again, I'm trying to figure out the route before I get on it. And then once I get on it, I just continue to figure things out as I go up this wall. Number two, down climb. I down climb as much as possible. And the reason why is this. It forces me to look at my footholds or the next foot placement that I need to do on my way down. So typically when you're climbing up, you look at the next handhold and you don't really focus on your footwork. So this really helps you focus on your footwork a lot. So I down climb, and also it gives me more time on the wall, and I also try to work my way down as controlled as possible. Number three, silent feet. This is one of the things that I include every time I climb, and it has really increased my footwork by a lot. I highly recommend this if you haven't been doing this yet. And what I'm doing is this, I'm placing my foot on the foot chip as softly and as controlled and as quiet as possible. I don't want to make any sound. If I hear a sound, I'm doing it wrong. You want to put that foothold or place that foot on the wall as silent as possible. And doing this really helps you being more accurate and really focus on your footwork, and you become a lot more efficient when you're climbing up your route. Number four, avoid readjusting. At all times, I'm trying to avoid readjusting my footwork or handhold. In this case, my handhold, I'm readjusting here, and I want to avoid that. The more you readjust, the more energy you're using on both your footwork readjustment and your handhold readjustment and your body position readjustment. So you guys, try not to readjust things if they're not needed. Sometimes it's needed, but in this case, it is not. Number five, flow. Flow is something that you've noticed an experienced climber have. When you see an experienced climber up on that wall and you tell yourself, oh my God, how does this guy have so much control? How is he so smooth and just moving so fluidly? How is he doing that? And this is the thing, you guys, all of this that I just mentioned, you practice and you focus a day on technique, it's gonna get you in that flow state. Try to be as controlled and as efficient as possible when you're doing each and every route in this session. And another thing is this, what has helped me really increase my flow is to actually do routes multiple times. When you're doing a route just once, you don't give both your mind and body enough time to understand what's happening up this wall. Like, why am I doing certain things? Why am I twisting in here? Why am I doing a flag or backstep? When you do the route multiple times, you give both your mind and body enough time to understand what is happening in this route. It starts to know, why are you flagging? Why are you backstepping? Why are you doing certain things? And this route becomes a lot more easier for you climbing it. What's great is this, when you go to the next route or difficult route that has a similar move that's needed to what you've been practicing, it becomes a lot more easier for you to do, because now your mind and body understands what you need to do in that situation. Number six, focus on one specific move, on a technical move. In this case, I'm going to be focusing on Dead Point. And the reason why is this. I want to take a move from one of my projects, which is, in this case, Flying Circus. And one of the cruxes here is this Dead Point to this crimp hold. As you can see, I'm falling a lot.
Yeah, that's it.
It is really difficult for me. So I want to take this move back to the gym and mimic it. And I want to do a progression of it. I want to get a feel of how am I going to place my footwork and just get a feel for it. Like just mimic it, get a feel of my body tension, how it feels. And in this case here, I'm just trying to figure out if it's best if I place my left foot up higher here or lower. And in this case, it's best if I place it here. But this is, again, this is just an example so you can get a clear idea of just focusing on a technical move. Because again, you guys, there are so many techniques that you gotta work on. The best thing to do is take a move that you're working on from one of your projects and try your best. If it's too difficult, do a progression from it. You guys, if you find this useful or helpful, please do hit that like button. If you haven't yet, please do subscribe so you can get more climbing tip videos just like this. I love you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.